My name is Heinke Fabricius, and I've been living in Berlin since 22 years now, but I'm not born here. I'm born in Transylvania, which is in Romania, and as you know, perhaps there are some different minority groups, so there are Hungarians, Romanians, Germans, and I'm half Hungarian, half German, and so I grew up the first years there, and after a couple of years we moved to Bucharest, where I went to school, and I made school time, primary school I did there, and it was in the late 70s when we moved to Western Germany, where, close to Stuttgart, nearby Stuttgart, and that's the area where I made my gymnasium time. But as I don't felt really comfortable there and I really wanted to move a little bit and to see a little bit more, I decided to go to Berlin, and after finishing school it's just that what I did. When I came to Berlin, it was Germany was still divided, but for me it was just very interesting to be here, because it was this ruptured situation was something what I really lived before, and I just was interested in the so-called Deutsche Frage, and that's why I came to Berlin, the western part for sure, and I never expected to take part in this big historical event. I really have to say, the evening of the 9th November, I really didn't realize what's going on, because I was here, but I couldn't understand so fast what's going up. But this is, it was very important, and I think it might have been as important if I would have been in another town or in another city at that moment, but I was here, and so it's strongly connected with Berlin, but for sure it's, for me it's important for whole Europe, because Europe isn't divided anymore. I was just for dinner with a friend. This was a wedding, and after this meeting I just took the underground going to Neukölln, where I lived at that time, and I just realized we a lot of many extremely lucky people in the underground, and I couldn't explain me why on a Thursday evening night at 10, half past 10, 11 or what it was, why are there so many lucky crying people. But I wasn't informed, and so I just was wondering about, and I thought it's something crazy in the air, but I couldn't understand. And only the next morning we put the radio on, because none of us thought about a big historical happening could be rolling on or happening. So it was just a surprise next morning, and then for sure nobody of us went to the university. We went all to Checkpoint Charlie or to the wall, and I took a lot of photographs, and it was just amazing for the next day. Nobody was at university. It was impossible to go to university. And I have to say, this was a very impressive day for me, and one of the strongest impressions was I went to Checkpoint Charlie because it was the closest checkpoint, and on the western side, because we expected all the people coming from the eastern side, and everybody was so happy and curious about what's going on. There was an old man, and I think at that time he might be 80 years old perhaps, and he had a big plastic sack or pocket full with 20 mark bills, exactly. And he gave to each child coming from the eastern part to the western part 20 marks as welcome. He was crying the whole time, he had tears in his eyes, and he just gave each child this money. And this was for me one of the most impressive things, because at that time I really understood very clearly that psychical depression was not only on the eastern side, it was on the western side too, and it was just kind of getting free too for the people from the western part. And I think that was extremely impressive for me, and in the end, I took really a lot of couple of days and weeks to be just on the way on my way to the town and to go to the eastern part and to visit it and just to have walks and to try to understand. And yeah, this process just still went on for the next years. There are a lot of changes for sure. The most obvious is perhaps the architecture and the growing up of the city and lots of young people, especially in the eastern part, because we had a huge range of young people coming from Western Germany, being very interested in Berlin and coming to live here. They came in the early 90s. Before, it was really completely another stuff going or coming to West Berlin. If you came from the western part of Germany to go to West Berlin, it was another topic, let's say, because the situation was like going into a closed city in turn by the wall and not being free, but perhaps not being free in moving, but perhaps being free in trying some music, some arts, what could be done here perhaps a little bit easier, or a little bit, yeah. And in the 90s, the situation really changed and you got kind of perspective you hadn't before, or a different perspective, and so there were very different kind of people coming later. Because then it was really like building up this new town and creating perspectives, and before it was more a little bit like finding a place for your own, in the western part I mean. And Berlin is quite unique in Germany as a city, or let's say as the capital. It would be very difficult to compare Berlin to Munich or to Hamburg, because the story of the city is so different, and the possibilities you got the last 20 years in Berlin are much higher in just trying something and making new projects than in a couple of other cities. And still, what makes Berlin attractive for a lot of creative working people, artists, musicians, people from the theater, you still have the possibility here to live without having too much money. And so you can handle it here and you can manage it. Sometimes it's not easy, but what you get is a kind of personal freedom which you couldn't keep for as a long time in some of the other cities, I think. And that's perhaps the reason why there are so many artists, musicians here in town. I think this is at least one of the differences. And it's open for all kind of people. You don't need always to explain why are you here, or what are you doing here. It's just you are here. I think the school system here is quite okay. So I'm satisfied, and that what I see here is they really try to enforce kids to learn and to show them how important it is to get a good education and to do it. For sure, not always it's easy to fulfill all that what the kids and the parents are asking for it, and sometimes politics are very slow in realizing what they have to do. The virtual discussion is that Germany decided to go to make the gymnasium only for 12 years, in 12 years, and not anymore in 13 years, like it was till yet. Because this was a big topic, the German students were always 1 year older than all the other European students when they start to go to university. And so they really lost some possibilities by this way, and actually we have this year or next year, I think, the first degree of pupils they end school after the 12th year. And so we have a very difficult situation, because we have now the kids from the 13th and from the 12th degree, they finish together, which will be a big problem on the working market and on the universities and so on. And so this is a big discussion at the moment. Other thing is for sure to work in integration, to help kids from other countries to learn German in a very fast, well done way. For example, then when they are at home and they don't speak German at home, so you really have to give them a lot of help that they can do their work at school here too. It's quite easy to escape the city. So you have a couple of seas, you have such a nice environment around Berlin, you have all the lakes, not seas, I'm sorry, I mean the lakes for sure. You have lakes in city, you have a lot of parks, you have, you just have to take your bike and drive 20 minutes, half an hour, and you're out of the city, if you want. So I don't mean if you're invited, then it will take longer for sure, but it's quite nice, and it's not so far away from the sea, it's not so far from Oderbruch and Poland, and I like the position from Berlin. That's what I really should add. Berlin isn't crowded. I have guests from Moscow or from other big cities, and they always tell me, okay, Berlin is like a big village. It's not a town. Might be critical, but for me it's just a compliment, because you have so many points and it's so international. And at the same time, it's not really crowded like big capitals in other parts of Europe or China or whatever. And it's still interesting and we have lots of possibilities. This is called Weißensee, and this is part of Pankow. And in this part of the town there's high school, but not high school, it's a university for arts. Kunsthochschule Berlin is located there, and so it's a quite nice neighborhood, because you have a lot of young students there, but at the same time you have very mixed people, mixed social groups. It's not it's quite mixed, and that's what I really like. And there is the sea, the lake Weißensee there. You can go with the boat in the lake, and there's this one nice park, and besides that there is the Jewish cemetery there, the biggest from Europe, and they just made for the Berlin Biennale, there was shown a film about Friedhof Weißensee, and this film is amazing. The most important thing is that Berlin should keep his openness. It had during the 90s, and it wouldn't lose this openness. I think that's the main idea, what I really would like to wish. I think we can't do anything against this development, that it will be more expensive during the next years. We have really to work on integration, which I think is quite important. At the same time, we have to work on being open, keeping openness, and there are some parts they developed very, very well. New architecture, I really love parts of the new architecture, and I think that's very important too. So I'm really very glad. Also, not only with very small parts in Kiez, which developed quite well, but I'm also glad with the Museum Island, and I hope they will really manage to create this Humboldt Forum, what is planned, and to have not only the European collections of art on the Museum Island, but also the world heritage, like we have the Asian, Indian, and African collections in Dahlem, actually, and the plans are on the long run to bring them up into the middle of the city, that they are realized as part of our heritage, as world heritage, like Museum Island is, and not only the European heritage, what we have actually there. Yeah, that's it.